Swamiji, what do you mean by the word you achieved enlightenment? See, enlightenment doesn't mean that you became extraordinary, or you became something like a superhuman, or you became some way superlative. No. By enlightenment, you achieve one thing, a deep, homely feeling, deeply rooted, centered in your being. You will feel a deep relaxation, you have come home, you are in your space. There is no other supernatural powers, or there is no other supernatural things associated with enlightenment. Having some supernatural power is no way related to enlightenment. Please understand, some powers may express through enlightened person, that is different, but the powers are not criteria. Just doing some magic or a miracle is no way related to enlightenment. So magic or supernatural things are not the real criteria of enlightenment. Enlightenment is a deep feeling or deep settledness or a total relaxation which happens inside your being. When you know your being, when you feel in tune with your being, or when you experience your energy, you achieve the state of enlightenment. Let me tell you an incident which happened in my life. At the age of 10, I was taken to a great master, Annamalai Swamigal. He was there in my native place, Thiruvannamalai. As a small boy, I was taken to him. Usually, you know, in India, people, the parents, they force the kids and take them to these swamis and all these temples. I was also taken by force. He was talking to a group of Westerners. He was talking that we are not body, we are not disturbed, we will not have any pain or suffering, we are beyond pains, we are beyond suffering, all these high, great Vedantic ideas. He was talking. When I heard that, first thing, I felt surprised. I was surprised. How can this be true? When my mom beats, I feel the pain. Of course, in India, you know, kids will be beaten by parents. When my mother beats me, I feel the pain. When my teacher fires me, I feel the suffering. How can he say this statement? I went to the house and I wanted to experiment, test what he said. I took a knife and tried to cut myself. I cut my thigh to see whether I have pain or not. Of course, I had pain. I was taken to the doctor. They put the stitching and first aid, everything. They've done everything. After a few days, I went to the Swami again. I asked him, what is this? What did you teach? I went and cut myself. Why did you say all these things that we don't have pain and we don't have suffering? I went and tested it on myself. That Swami made a beautiful statement. Don't worry, my son. Do this small meditation technique. When time comes, you will understand what I said. Now you may not have understood, but when time comes, you will understand, realize what I said. Do this meditation. He taught me a simple technique of searching the source of your thoughts. Just start searching the source of your thoughts. So I said, all right, now you are teaching me the meditation, it's okay. But what about the pain which I am having? What about the suffering which I am having? Now I will do this meditation. This he could have told me earlier itself. What about the suffering? He told me the beautiful statement. Don't bother about this suffering. The courage to experiment the truth which you have is more than enough. That will liberate you. This one or two small mistakes, these small things, don't bother about it. It is worth doing. Or these troubles are worth facing. the courage to experiment with the truth, that's the greatest thing anybody can have. You have that, that is enough. That will guide you, that will lead you to the ultimate experience at the end of the life. Of course, that one statement, the courage to experiment with the truth, that one statement gave me the courage to experiment with all these truths. To reach the being level, we need only one thing, the courage to experiment with the truths.